This is section 7.5, graphing y minus k equals a times x minus h squared. We are going to graph parabolas with this form, and we're going to learn how to find the vertices and axes of symmetry. Vertices is plural for vertex, axes is plural for axis. Today's video is going to be a little different. All I'm going to go over is the vocabulary on your handout. We are going to do the rest of the examples in class tomorrow after the short quiz on 7.1 to 7.4. So all you have to do is fill in the vocabulary, watch this video, and you are going to work in groups on Wednesday to do some of the examples. Here we go. First, we have to define a parabola. A parabola is the smooth curve created by the equation y equals x squared. So on the table, I have a set of values for x and a set of values for y, plugging in x into the equation for the parabola. And all you have to do is plot the points. So we have -3, 9, -2, 4, -1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 2, 4, and 3, 9. All the y's represent the square of the x's, and you connect the dots in a nice smooth way. This is called a parabola. You notice that it has a U-shaped, and that's going to be a shape that you're going to be quite familiar with after this lesson. So this is called a parabola. The axis of symmetry of the parabola is basically where the middle of the parabola is. So if we have x comma y on the parabola, negative x comma y is also there. You notice that for 3, 9, we have -3, 9. For 2, 4, we have -2, 4. This is a mirror image across the y-axis. In this case, the y-axis is the axis of symmetry. It's basically the center of the parabola, where on each side of the axis is a reflection of the other. The vertex of a parabola is the point where the parabola crosses the axis of symmetry. So we know the axis of symmetry is the y-axis. This little green dot here represents the vertex at 0, 0. It will also be the highest or the lowest point of the parabola. That's going to be the vertex, basically where it goes from down to up or up to down. Now, if we were to graph y equals negative x squared, you would reflect it across the x-axis. So you remember the shape of the original graph, and if you don't, go to the previous slide by going back a few seconds. But if we were to reflect it, you see the values in the table on the left, and I'm just plotting them one by one, and you connect the dots. It's the same graph, but reflected across the x-axis. Now you notice that the graph is an upside-down U, and it opens downward. So that'll tell us something in a few minutes when we get to one of the definitions. So at the beginning, you might want to just plot points. After a while, you'll get the hang of it and how it looks. And if you have a graphing calculator, you're more than welcome to use it. And I mentioned the website earlier, metacalculator.com, and you can try using that calculator at home when you're doing these problems. Here's the graph of y equals ax squared. A is going to be the coefficient of x. So the graph of y equals ax squared opens upward if a is greater than 0 and downward if a is less than 0. We'll look at that on the next slide. Right now, let's look at this other point. The larger the absolute value of a is, the narrower the graph is. So a can take on the value of any real number. We're generally going to be working with fractions, rational numbers, integers, etc. So here you have a standard graph of y equals x squared in blue. If we were to graph y equals 2x squared, you notice how a is bigger. The absolute value of a went from 1 to 2, so the parabola is narrower. Likewise, if we go to y equals 1/2 x squared in green, you notice that it's wider than the original blue graph. So the value of a, at least the magnitude, the number, the absolute value of a, will tell you whether the graph is wide or narrow. The closer it is to 0, the wider it is. The farther it is from 0, the narrower it is. We can reflect these across the x-axis, and that was the original point. So for y equals negative x squared, that's the blue one reflected downward. You notice how with a being positive 1 here, the graph opens up. But with negative 1 at being a, the graph opens down. Likewise, we can do the same with y equals negative 2x squared. It opens downward. And y equals negative 1/2 x squared. So what you notice is that the coefficient a, the absolute value, affects not just the width, And the sign affects whether it opens up upward or downward. So again, when A is positive, it's going to open upward. When A is negative, it's going to open downward. Now we have the graph of y equals a times x minus h squared. What we're going to do is you take a look at some of these. We're adding one layer at a time. So let's go ahead and graph y equals a times x minus h squared. The way you do this is that you're going to slide the graph of y equals a x squared horizontally h units. So if h is positive, you're going to slide it to the right. If h is negative, you're going to slide it to the left. And that does another thing. That moves the vertex from 0, 0 to h, 0. And the axis of symmetry is now the line x equals h. So let's take a look at how this works. So we have changed the graph from y equals 1 half x squared in blue to y equals 1 half x minus 3 squared in red. You notice that with h being positive, and again, don't look at the negative sign. We're just looking at the number here, which is 3. You're going to slide it to the right. 3 units. So you notice that the old vertex was 0, 0. Now the new vertex is 3, 0. The axis of symmetry is also x equals 3. So if we change it to 1 half times x plus 3 squared, now remember the form is x minus h. So now that h is negative 3 because it's x minus negative 3. That gives you an x plus 3. You'll slide it to the left 3 units. So now your vertex is negative 3, 0. And your axis of symmetry is x equals negative 3. Now we'll look at the graph of y minus k equals ax squared. So, to graph y minus k equals ax squared, we are now going to slide the graph of y equals ax squared vertically k units. If k is greater than 0, we're going to slide it upward. If k is less than 0, we'll slide it down. So you're basically shifting the graph based on the value of k in the y direction, either up or down. This graph will have a vertex of 0, k, and its axis is the line x equals 0. So the axis doesn't change because you're only moving the graph up and down. So let's see how this works. We have our original blue graph, y equals 1 half x squared. If we graphed y minus 3 equals 1 half x squared, our value of k is 3. Remember, k is the number after the negative sign. So y minus k, here k is 3. So we shift the graph up 3 units, and our vertex has now gone from 0, 0 to 0, 3, which is the value of k. The axis of symmetry remains the line x equals 0 because we haven't moved it in a horizontal direction. Likewise, if we have y plus 3 equals 1 half x squared, now our value of k is negative 3 because it's y minus negative 3 to give us y plus 3. And the green graph shows that we have shifted the original blue graph down 3 units because k is negative. The vertex of this graph is 0, negative 3, negative 3 being the value of k, and the axis of symmetry still is x equals 0 because we haven't moved it horizontally. So when you have a k value after the y, that's going to tell you to shift it up or down. When we had the h value after the x, that will tell you to shift it left or right, and the a tells you whether to open it up, down, and how wide or narrow it is. And now we're going to put it all together. Now we have the graph of y minus k equals a times x minus h squared. To graph this, we will do 3 things. First, you have to account for a. This is basically what we're doing before. We're doing it step by step. You have to slide the graph of y equals ax squared horizontally h units and vertically k units. So the first thing we have to do is convert y equals x squared to y equals ax squared. Let's use a graph. Here, our graph is y minus 2 equals 2 times x minus 4 squared. So what is the a value? It's 2. 2 is a. So that tells us 2 things. First of all, because the a value is positive, our parabola is going to open upward. Also, since the absolute value of a is still 2, the graph is going to be narrower than the original blue graph. So let's keep that in mind. Now, we have to do the h and the k. First, we slide it horizontally h units. H here is 4. Remember, x minus h, so h is 4. You're going to shift it right 4 units. You know that k is 2 because it's y minus 2, y minus k, k is 2. So we're going to shift the graph up 2 units. and you just plot it, narrower than the original blue graph. Now, this graph has a vertex of h, k. So h, k is 4, 2. That checks out because h is 4 and k is 2. And the axis symmetry is the line x equals h. Well, the middle of the parabola is here at x equals 4, which is h. So you just have to do it step by step. And it'll become quite familiar to you after you do enough practice. The sliding part, the shifting part, will come pretty quickly because you're going to have to do it a lot when we graph in chapter 9. Let's do one more example before we get to the examples. We have y equals negative 1/2 x squared. So go ahead and see if you can kind of do this one yourself. At least figure out where the shifting is going to be. I've already told you that since a is negative 1/2, the graph is a little wider than the original parabola of y equals x squared. And because it's negative, it's facing downward, or opening up downward. So now you just have to figure out how much you're shifting this graph. Well, I guess I should give you an equation. So y minus 3 equals negative 1/2 x plus 2 squared. So you're going to shift it left 2 because h is negative 2. Remember, it's x minus negative 2. So we're going to shift it left 2 spots. And then we're going to shift it up 3 spots because y minus k is 3. So we shift it that way. And now we just move the parabola that's already in green and put it in purple. The graph shape is the same. So the vertex of this graph is at negative 2, 3, which represent the values of h and k, and the axis symmetry goes through the line x equals h, or x equals negative 2. So you're going to be solving a lot of problems on homework, and we're going to go over the examples in class tomorrow. If you have any questions, please email me in the meantime. If this is somewhat confusing to you, go ahead and either rewatch the video, go through the book, or look up other YouTube videos. I don't claim to be the monopoly of truth here. All right, happy studying, and I will see you in class tomorrow.